please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Mr. Ranbir Singh, the president and CEO of the company, joins in now. Thanks a lot, Mr. Singh, for joining in. First up, if you could just make a simple clarification, how much stake do promoters hold as of now? What was the disclosure that the company gave to the exchanges over the weekend? Who sold, who bought? Were they a part of the promoters?
Good morning. Earlier, the total holding was in the tune of 70%. Now, the overall holding is, promoter holding is around 66%. And one promoter family has sold around 6 to 7%. And out of that, around 2% is purchased by within the family. So total dilution is around 4.5% in the market.
All right. Hi, Mr. Singh. Sir, your stock is up and about even after that one promoter entity did sell a stake, telling you that there have been some big buyers as well. If you could clarify to us, sir, who are the buyers? Are there some funds that have bought this stake that was being sold by the promoter entity? And also, if you could help us out, sir, now it's at around 66%. Do the other promoters intend to take the stake back up to maybe 67-68%?
Immediately, I cannot tell about this thing, but whatever dilution has happened, I think this will be stable now. And the overall, these 4.5% has gone into the market, you know, it has increased the float and the taking has improved because of this in the market. Because GNA Axles share is in a high demand and the performance of the company is improving.
Mr. Singh, but that promoter who was selling, has he already sold out or is there more supply that could hit the market?
So it has not hit the market and it is already our shares in the open market were very little according to the company size and the overall demand of the shares.
Yes.
It has not affected at all our share price.
Okay.
Yeah, we can see it has not affected your share price, Mr. Singh. In fact, on the other hand, the share prices have only gone up. That usually happens when some influential investor enters a stock despite the promoter selling. So if you can give us some clarity on whether you have the book or not with you, which could tell you, you know, who could the buyers be? Someone, some fund, some influential investor. Any clarity on that?
Immediately, I do not have the details readily available with me.
All right, Mr. Singh, then the takeaway is that, in fact, promoter holding is at around 66%. One promoter entity sold roughly around 6 to 7%. Out of that, another promoter has bought close to 2%. So that's the takeaway in terms of promoter shareholding. Well, let's talk about your business then, sir. How is business on the ground? I remember you joined us in October 2017. At that point of time, you told us that order inflows to the tune of nearly around 60 crores on a per month basis. Is that number holding at around 60 crores? Has it increased? Do you see good demand on the ground?
The numbers are holding and we are very hopeful further this will improve in the coming financial year because North American class 8 and above vehicles outlook has come and next year again they are growing by 20%.
Okay.
And our domestic market is also performing very good and tractors has grown up very well and now stable. And commercial vehicle segment is also growing because a lot of infrastructure investments are there by the government. So it has given us a positive effect in the demand.
Okay, so the 60 crore order inflow that you're talking about amounts to about 360 crores in terms of revenue for the next half of this year. Is that a possibility? And you spoke about that going higher. To what level can it grow in the next coming months and FY19 itself?
Actually, this year, as we have originally given our targets to cross 15%, so we are sticking to the overall growth. And and in coming year, we are further investing. And those investments will be completed by 31st March this financial year. And next year, again, we are planning to grow by 15%.
Wow. So by FY20, what can your revenue number look like, sir? And I remember in the last quarter, there was a bit of disappointment on margins because of some Forex impact of around 0.5% approximately. This time around, margins could hold at around that 15.5-16%. Is that doable or can you better that number?
Third Q3 is not complete and balance sheet is not as yet completed. And a lot of fluctuations are there in the steel, you know, steel growth. Incremental increase in the steel prices is there. It is definitely it is affecting some margins in general. But overall profit will grow because the top line is growing, so overall profit margins will grow.
So FY20, what should your revenue number look like, sir? You were talking about growing 15% this year. Next year as well, you're going to be doing 15% or so. Is that...
As earlier we have declared in 20, we are targeting to touch or cross 1,000 crores level top line.
Cross how much, sir, by FY20?
1,000 crores.
1,000 crores by FY20, that would be much more than the 15% growth that you are projecting, sir.
No, this is the lowest level, I'm telling you, but it all depends on the market also, North American, European and domestic market. And our main mission is to keep intact, and our facilities and our infrastructure should be intact. The moment the market will behave or demand will be there, and we should be competent to feed our customers.
So, Mr. Singh, your current capacity is what? I remember it was 3.5. Then you were telling us it would increase to around 4.5 million units. What is it currently, and where do you see that go?
It is 4 million components. The capacity will be completed by 31st March. That will be 4 million components.
4 million, okay.
And and we are putting up a new plant that is for SUV axle shafts and light passenger vehicle axle shafts, so which will come up by end of next year. The infrastructure will be completed. That plant will start commercial sales by end of 2018.
All right.
That is how we are targeting.
And before we let you go, Mr. Singh, if you could tell us how much does domestic contribute in terms of your revenue? And you spoke about that growing faster. What is the expected growth rate there?
The dependency on domestic is around 50%, and overall growth in export and domestic will be around 15 to 17%.
Okay.